home estimate. Now that's a deal. Call 1-800-697-1961.
Howdy folks, I'm Tex Earnhardt here with Earnhardt Ford.
Spring is here, and the savings are growing at Earnhardt. Get up to $10,000 off MSRP. Yes, 10 grand on new 2016 F-150 Super Crew trucks. Or lease a new 2017 Focus for only $169 per month. Take a test drive at the I-10 and Ray Road in Chandler, or find us online at EarnhardtFord.com.
Stop in and see us at Earnhardt Ford, and that ain't no bull.
The division rival Dodgers are coming to town. Get to Chase Field on Saturday, April 22nd, and pick up the D-backs car sunshade, courtesy of Safelite Auto Glass. Visit dbacks.com.
We're looking for something that's comfortable but yet durable and that's going to last us a really long time. I don't want to buy new furniture every couple of years.
It's custom made, so you know it's good quality.
I'm just speechless because it's perfect.
Save up to 30% plus extra savings this weekend only at Bassett.
Well, a warning to parents this morning, an Easter toy being recalled because it could potentially be deadly. They're called hatch and grow Easter eggs, and if a kid eats them, they could expand inside their body, putting them in life-threatening pain. Now, surgery would be required to get it out. They were sold at Target stores nationwide from February to March. Naval commanders say vaping not going to be allowed anymore on any U.S. Navy ships. It's a temporary policy that starts next month. Officials say it is to protect the fleet and sailors, citing multiple explosions and burns that put some of those sailors out of work or on light duty. The Navy is going to reevaluate the policy, but sailors can ask for an extension. They're still going to be able to vape, though, on land. No, hey.
Allison, you could make a big payday the next time you get bumped from a flight. I know I will volunteer for this one. After that massive scandal with United Airlines, you know, when police were dragging that man out of his seat when they needed to make room for flight staff. Well, now Delta is offering over $9,000 in comps to get people to volunteer their seats. Before that, the most agents could offer was $1,300. So now it's not cold, hard cash. They are vouchers, but easily that could buy you another vacation, maybe to an even better destination. The White House is considering privatizing the air traffic control system. Right now, the Federal Aviation Administration manages those operations. Critics say, though, the FAA has been too slow rolling out new technology. But others claim that private business interests are bad for service.
That money-making thing stays on the ground. Once we push those throttles forward, competition goes out the window.
The ATC's union backed a move to privatize last year, but they're evaluating President Trump's proposal thus far.
He's accused of being an unlicensed contractor. For months, he dodged me. We finally tracked him down.
Eric.
We're all set. Thank you.
Hey, yeah, I don't want to talk to you. Hey, Eric, what do you have to say about this?
On the steps of the courthouse, Eric Morales is silent.
What about all the money, Eric, that you said you were going to get back to these people and never did?
About what he's accused of doing to unsuspecting Mesa homeowners like Janine Cohen.
He said, I need more money for materials. And every few days, I'm going to go get materials, and I need more money. But nothing was ever delivered.
$329,000. That's what the Register of Contractors says he took for work left like this. Landscaping, stucco, roof work, unlicensed to do any of it.
Days went by, he didn't show up. The trenches were all ripped up and dug, and the work wasn't happening.
Oh, Morales did make promises. In emails to me, I will get in contact with the Cohens. I will complete everything. I will love to do an interview with you, just not this week. Never happened.
You said you were going to do an interview with me. Never did. Why was that?
Though investigators say Morales took advantage of six homeowners, the 23-year-old is facing one felony count of fraud. The trial is scheduled for this summer. Now, the Register of Contractors says Morales gave homeowners a fake license number. Make sure you check that license number before hiring any contractor. To do that, go to abc15.com, click on sections, and let Joe know. Need my help? Call the Better Business Bureau volunteer team. You can email me or find me on Facebook. I'm Investigator Joe Ducey. If you've got a problem, let me know.
Thanks, Joe. Hey, this story causing a lot of outrage this morning. A school lunch lady says she was fired just for giving kids, hungry kids, food. Debbie Salzman worked at the same Ohio elementary school for 14 years. She says when a kid could not afford lunch, they would get a cheese sandwich instead. That meant other students would know that they did not have the cash for a regular meal.
In my heart, and that child tells me they're hungry, do I believe them or just say no?
Tough call. Well, the school says that Debbie was actually fired because she was giving extra food to her grandkids. She does admit that that's true, but she was breaking the rule for other kids too who needed it.
If you're looking for a place to party, but also want to get in touch with your spiritual side, there is a church in Old Town Scottsdale. It might be the right choice for you. That was the case last night. A new church called Church Alive had a service inside a nightclub. All are welcome, even someone on the way out of happy hour. The pastor says he is willing to do whatever it takes to get people to give it a chance.
I was just kind of talking to him. He's like, well, can I get a beer? And I was like, absolutely. So yeah, I bought him a beer next door and he came to the service and he loved it.
Now to clarify, the bar isn't open during service inside the church. They serve coffee instead. Whether you believe these two concepts mix or not, this is just one layer of being unconventional. Monday on ABC 15 Mornings, we're going to have a look at this church's unique recruiting methods and what lies ahead for the future of this particular congregation.
That'll be interesting to see. Hey, if you're getting out there this morning, temperature is not too bad because you're saying we'll get a little bit warmer later on.
Yeah, pretty mild start today, and we're not going to get too warm today. Although, don't get me wrong, it is going to get warm. We're going to be in the upper 80s. But right now, it's a pretty comfortable 66 degrees. There's just a very light wind out there, and you see that live look of downtown Phoenix in the background. Clear skies all day long. That's what you can expect across the valley right now. Some folks already popping into the 70s this morning. Deer Valley at 70, Levine at 70, Ahwatukee and Tempe still sitting in the mid 60s at this time. Across the state, we're slowly starting to warm up. Flagstaff finally getting out of below freezing temperatures, sitting at 48. It was cold there overnight. 46 in the Grand Canyon right now, 63 in Bullhead City. Out on the east side, 63 in Safford, 55 in Sholo. Looking at clouds and radar, clear skies across the state right now. We do have some clouds off to our northwest that are going to push into our area on Sunday, early morning. So tomorrow, Easter Sunday, you will see some light cloud cover, but we're going to stay dry. Today, we're going to warm up really nicely. It's going to be in the mid to upper 70s along the rim, 70 degrees in Sholo, 77 in Payson, 79 in Kingman. Further to the south, 88 degrees in Casa Grande, 82 in Nogales, 85 in Douglas. 88 is what we're expected to top out at here in Phoenix. Across the valley, we'll see those upper 80s all over the place, really. 87 in Scottsdale, 87 in Paradise Valley, 87 down in Queen Creek. Sunny skies, and we are a couple of degrees above average for this time of year. On the west side, more upper 80s, a lot of 88s on the west side. 88 at Luke Air Force Base, 88 in Avondale, 88 in Levine. If you're planning to get out, hour by hour breaks down like this. So we are sitting in the mid 60s right now. We're going to warm up to the 70s by mid morning. By lunchtime, we'll already be in the 80s, but we're going to top out at about 88 degrees today. Tomorrow, the warm up starts to happen. We're going to creep into the 90s for Easter. That'll happen by later in the afternoon, but then the 90s are going to stick around for the start of your work week. Then cooler temperatures move in. The breezes pick up just a bit by midweek and drop us back into the 80s to round out the rest of your work week forecast.
Thanks, Nohe. Hey, happening right now, security high in Rome as thousands of people pour into the Vatican City for the Easter weekend. Police are out in full force, too. They're checking bags with bomb-sniffing dogs, scouring every inch of the Vatican to make sure it is safe. Pope Francis hosting numerous public events, too, including an Easter Vigil Mass in St. Peter's Square today. Well, one church is taking a very unique approach to bringing in parishioners this Easter. They're offering drive-through prayers. This Louisiana church has been doing this for 3 years now, and anybody who wants a prayer just has to pull up through the driveway, doesn't even have to get out of their car. The goal here, though, is to build unity.
with all the darkness and the separation of things that are occurring in America, but we can come together of all walks of life in prayer.
At least one church here in Phoenix does drive-through prayers. Livestreams Church has a drive-through service several nights a week. Hey, still ahead, absolute mayhem inside of a train station. What police did that sparked this stampede. And next, I'm going to watch Nohe and I try out this mini obstacle course, how all of this fun is actually playing into a really great cause.
Luxury savings days at La Mesa RV. Our huge selection from Fleetwood, Tiffin, and Winnebago is everyday low price. This new Fleetwood Discovery LXE is discounted over $107,000. Get luxury savings now at La Mesa RV in Phoenix and Mesa.
Spring is a great time to add instant value to your home. So call AZ Valley Windows now for expertly installed Infinity by Marvin Windows. Fiberglass windows that stand up to Arizona heat and add curb appeal. Call now and save during our window blowout sale. Get free installation on a house full of new windows. Ask about 12 months, no interest, and a bonus, $100 Visa gift card with your purchase. Plus, call during this program for a free gift with your in-home estimate.
First Watch, now open in your neighborhood.
Looking for a job with one of the highest starting wages around? Synchrony Financial is hiring call center representatives in Phoenix. From day one, you'll enjoy a competitive salary and a benefits package that includes a 401k with company match, a monthly incentive bonus, and health care. Apply today at syfcareers.com or text SYF9 to 90206. Again, text SYF9 to 90206 for more information. Synchrony Financial. Engage with us.
It's a fiesta of savings at La Mesa RV. See thousands of new and used RVs, like this new Dutchman Denali Lite, discounted to just $234 per month. Huge selection and discounts. The fiesta of savings at La Mesa RV in Phoenix and Mesa.
Big news on Larry's sports future. I hear you're trading in your football career for softball.
That's right, Stephanie. But it's just for one day. Join ABC 15 for my double play celebrity softball game.
Saturday, April 22nd. Get your tickets at LarryFitzgerald.com.
ABC 15 Mornings, protecting you from scammers.
Hackers are holding computers for ransom.
Your most accurate forecast.
Temperatures back into the 90s.
A little boy's generosity isn't going unnoticed.
Gave his gaming system to a police department.
Watch it first on ABC 15 Mornings.
Two big closures to tell you about on the roads this weekend. The first one is on the I-17 northbound from the Durango curve to McDowell. Drivers are going to have to get off at 19th Avenue, and this one is going to last all weekend long. That second one in the East Valley, the Loop 101 Price Freeway northbound, that's going to be closed between the US 60 and the Loop 202 Red Mountain Freeway. ADOT is going to be installing some new signs on that 4-mile stretch through Tempe Friday night into Saturday morning. For more on these closures, you can visit abc15.com. Okay, guys, get ready for some friendly competition. The 2030 Club is in Scottsdale, right?
Correct.
Is hosting its annual Brokers for Kids and Agents Benefiting Children event.
So this is where like 60 different teams take part, and they compete in all kinds of fun games. Ben and Kelly joining us this morning. Thanks so much for being here with
thank
us,
you for having
guys.
Us. Thank you for having us.
So 60 teams competing in all kinds of stuff. I'm picturing like just pure madness, but tons of fun.
It's pretty close. It's pretty close. This year we've actually got about 70 teams participating between the two sides of the event. And
70 teams, almost 70?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Ooh, so that's crazy.
The Brokers for Kids side has been around for 18 years, and we've grown basically from a weekend party at Indian School Park. Now we're at Scottsdale Stadium, and there's almost 600 people there competing.
Yeah, it's crazy. And here's the fun thing, or the great thing about it, is it's all benefiting, you know, a good cause.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
Yeah, where does that money go?
Well, there's a couple charity partners, and we raise money for multiple charities. The Care Fund is a charity partner for Agents Benefiting Children, and then Boys Help Girls Hope for BFK, Brokers for Kids.
That's awesome. BFK. That's so bro-y. I love it. Okay, so let's show you some of the competition here because we want to get to it. This is going to be pretty fun. What should we do first? Let's do the football. Okay, I mean, I told
Allison's been, she's trying to redeem herself because these guys were here last time, right?
Can you hold this for me, please? Yep. Okay, here I go. Watch this. Bruce Arians, if you need a backup. Here I go. All right.
Hey, that wasn't too bad. That wasn't awful. That wasn't awful.
So some people are going to be doing that. Also, no one's going to try our hand at cornhole here. Well, I go ahead and do this.
I attempted a competition at one point in Scottsdale. I was not on the professional team. Oh, but I should have been. I should have been.
That is incredible. Okay, let's also make sure we get you guys over here.
Bocce ball.
Is that what it is?
Right? Yeah.
I don't know how you pronounce it.
So bocce ball is sort of a mix of like croquet versus...
It's an art form.
It's an art form, is for sure. So the point is to hit, you want to get close to the little white ball, and then you can knock one another out, right?
Okay, so that's the whole point of this thing. It's a friendly competition. Now, I know it looks like fun, and unfortunately, not everybody can compete in this part, but the public can take part. So tell us how.
So every year we have a raffle. Valley Toyota Dealers either donates a car or you can win a $15,000 cash prize.
Ooh, wow.
So the best way to get involved is to go to a website, www.bfk2017.com.
All right.
And you can purchase raffle tickets there. You don't have to be present to win. And if you win, we either call you or email you. We get your contact information and we let you know as soon as it happens.
Wow, that is so awesome. Okay, wow. So can people go watch or is that a closed event at Scottsdale?
So the event itself is actually kind of a thank you from us to the different real estate companies vendors involved.
Okay.
So it's not open to the public, but you don't have to be present to win the raffle.
Right.
So if you are a commercial real estate company or a residential real estate company, it's a great way to get involved, give back to the community, meet other people in the industry.
Okay, so awesome. So are you guys going to be competing in this?
No, we'll be working to make sure it's going smoothly.
I can't believe it. Okay, I guess some of these guys are. They're ready for this. It's all going down next week, but make sure you take part in the raffle. Thank you, guys.
Thank you very much.
We'll be back with your top stories in just a bit.
If you're constantly adjusting the thermostat to keep your home comfortable, then now's the best time to call AZ Valley Windows during our window blowout sale. It's great to hear from homeowners in Scottsdale, Sun City, and throughout the Phoenix area. Thanks for calling, and there's still time left to take advantage of free installation on a house full of new windows. We offer high-performance Infinity by Marvin windows with high-quality fiberglass construction so they won't warp in the Arizona sun. Beautiful windows that are easy to operate and enhance security. We also have savings on sliding patio doors. Time's running out to call. Remember, during our window blowout sale, get free installation on a house full of new windows. Ask about 12 months, no interest. Get the bonus $100 Visa gift card with your purchase. And last chance during this program to call and receive a free $50 restaurant.com gift card with your in-home estimate. Replace your windows now. 1-800-697-1961.
Chevy is the most awarded car company 3 years in a row.
Really?
Let's see how quickly you can read through all their awards.
2017 Motor Trend Car of the Year.
Kelley Blue Book 2016 Best Resale Value.
2016 JD Power Highest Quality Ranking.
Wow. 10 Best Blah Blah Blah.
2016.
Only about 90 more to go.
That's a lot of awards.
Current qualified competitive lessees can get this Chevy Cruze for around $139 a month, or find your tag to get $3,500 total cash allowance on select Cruze vehicles when you finance with GM Financial. Find new roads at your local Chevy dealer.
You have a list of things. None of those things say wander around a warehouse looking for somebody to help you, or walk out not knowing if you got exactly what you need. Nope, you have a list of things, and Ace has them, from the brands you trust. We also have people like Pete, who ask the right questions to make sure you get everything you need. Because at Ace, we have our own list, and great service is at the top.
Ace is the place with the helpful hardware, folks.
Everybody, stop what you're doing and download the Quick Trip app.
Thanks for getting the word out at Maria Daniels 88. That was aggressive. Download the Quick Trip app and order some deliciousness.
This is ABC 15 News, taking action.
Two sisters killed in a wrong-way crash, and now their mother speaking only to us here about the tragedy and how she wants her girls to be remembered.
The immigration battle intensifying here at home. What local law enforcement say they are going to do to make sure everyone feels safe.
Good morning, everybody. It is just about 8:30 now on a Saturday here. I'm Allison Rodriguez.
And I'm Nohe Lonnie Graff. Thank you so much for making us a part of your day. And it is shaping up to be a gorgeous day.
It was
outside.
Gorgeous. We were just out there a couple minutes ago and getting our sports on.
Yeah.
And it was sunny, started to feel nice and warm already.
Super, super comfortable. So if you're planning to get outside as you have that last cup of coffee and plan for your day, 66 degrees right now, but by 9, we'll already be warmed up into the 70s. Maybe you're going to hit the links today. Your golfing forecast breaks down like this. We'll be at the low 70s by 9 this morning. By noon, we'll be into the low 80s, but we're going to top out at 88 degrees. I've also got that Easter forecast. I know everybody has plans for tomorrow, so we'll talk about that more in just a couple minutes.
Well, breaking right now, police are on the scene of a serious crash involving a semi-truck and a vehicle. We want to give you a live look at the scene. Our photojournalist Rick Lebo showing up there now. This is near 67th Avenue in Glendale. We're working to get some brand new information about how all of this happened, but you see that response there. We're trying to figure out if there are any injuries as well. Now, Mary Ellen Resendez, we believe, is going to be heading over there, but we do have a crew already there, as I mentioned. A photojournalist, Rick Lebo, on scene there right now, hoping to gather some information about exactly what happened here, but you can expect some delays if you're going to be traveling through this area this morning.
Also new overnight, two people shot in Tempe and the shooter is on the run right now. Police say they found the victims on Hermosa Drive near Southern and McClintock. Investigators say someone inside a car fired shots at another vehicle and managed to hit the man and woman inside. The shooter then drove off. Both victims, we're told, are expected to be okay. A man is in the hospital this morning after accidentally shooting himself. This happened near Tatum Boulevard and Union Hills Drive. Phoenix PD found the man alone inside his trailer. They say he was getting ready for a camping trip when the gun went off. We are working to find out if he is okay.
Only on ABC 15 now, we are hearing this morning from the mother of two girls killed in a wrong-way crash. This one happening on the I-17 yesterday morning. Their parents telling us Carly and Kelsey Richardson are their girls who died yesterday. Those girls' mother say they were headed to the Grand Canyon to catch the sunrise. Well, that's when a second vehicle driving south in the northbound lane hit them head on. The driver of that car also died.
Bottom line, they're gone. And it's not like they're coming back. And I feel for the other parents who have also lost a child.
You can almost hear the shock in her voice still. Carly and the wrong way driver were both GCU students. Kelsey went to school in North Carolina. DPS now investigating if impairment played a factor in this wrong way crash. Now, we have had to tell you about this kind of situation way too many times, and it just doesn't get any easier. Now, in just the first 4.5 months of the year, DPS has taken more than 570 calls for wrong-way drivers. Now, not every call did turn out to be valid, but almost every wrong-way crash here in Arizona did involve some sort of impairment, from drugs to alcohol.
Absolute chaos inside this train station. Take a look at this video. You see the people running for what they think is their lives. More than a dozen people actually hurt in this stampede, and all of it because of a taser. This happened in Penn Station in New York City. Police say they used a taser on an uncooperative passenger, but people nearby heard that crack and they thought it was a gunshot. That is what led to this frightening scene as people rushed to safety. 16 people hurt in all, many of them just leaving their luggage behind. We are learning, though, the people hurt are all going to be okay. Imagine driving down the highway and then this lands in front of you. That's what happened to a driver in Oregon, the pilot, in the middle of training a rookie when there was some sort of a problem with the oil pressure, and they landed right there, smack dab in front of a guy just trying to make his way to work. Nobody was hurt, though.
Developing now, a disabled man who's lived in the United States for more than 20 years could be deported to Afghanistan on Monday. Mahir Muhammad is being detained in our state in Florence after he was picked up by ICE in Missouri. He has a criminal record for assault and he was ordered to be deported back in 2003. While his family says they are worried for his safety because two of his brothers worked as translators for the U.S. Army in Afghanistan. Protesters turning out in full force as a California judge tries to decide if President Trump's order against sanctuary cities is constitutional. The president wanting to deny federal funds to cities that do not cooperate with immigration officials. San Francisco and Santa Clara filed for an injunction to stop that order, but federal attorneys are arguing that so little money is involved that it's a waste of time to really fight over it.
Here in Phoenix, the city council is trying to figure out how best to handle immigration issues. Phoenix Police Chief Jerry Williams took part helping answer questions. When it comes to support for the refugee community, immigration enforcement, and how police can help families dealing with the federal actions of the government.
It's challenging to sit through these talks and discussions, but it's healthy to sit through these talks and discussions because we're able to really create a product that's going to make the community feel safe, make our officers feel safe, and still be in compliance with the law.
Chief Williams stresses it is critically important to hear all sides, and she's listening to concerns from the entire community.
Well, all new this morning, Phoenix police just arrested a suspect accused of stealing cars and beating up a man. The first stolen car reported near East Thunderbird Road and Cave Creek. Police brought out their chopper to try and chase him. That's when the suspect got out of the car near Tatum and Bell Road, assaulted a man, and then stole another vehicle. The police chopper tracked him down to Fleming's Spring Road, where the suspect was then arrested.
Marana police are trying to find the Good Samaritan who saved a woman after she crashed into this canal. Look at that photo. Police say she ran her car into the irrigation canal here near Marana and Wentz Roads. Well, when she got out, she fell into the canal, and we have told you how strong those currents can be. She actually started to get washed away. Right then, a passerby saw her, saw what was happening, jumped to action, and actually pulled her out of the water. The driver was taken to the hospital. She's not seriously hurt. Police, though, want to find that Good Samaritan so they can thank them, really, for, you know, for saving that woman's life.
I know, right place at the right time. You see somebody in, you know, trouble and you jump in there.
Yeah.
Oh my gosh, that's crazy. Okay, let's talk about your most accurate forecast today. Warm, I've heard a lot of people at the pool this past week. So you think another good weekend for that?
It is pool weather. I mean, I think it's safe to say spring is here. Whether you plan on a pool day, biking, hiking, running, you're getting the green light. And today is the better day to do it because we're going to top out at 88 today. Tomorrow, though, we're going to move back into the 90s. Also, keep in mind, if you are heading outdoors, man, those pollen levels are high, almost as high as they get. Mulberry, poplar, juniper giving everybody the sniffles and sneezes. So just keep that in mind as you head out the door. Wash those hands frequently. Wash your face. That always helps to remove the pollen off of your face.
Well, Uber drivers, your taxes are about to get a lot more complicated. What you need to know so Uncle Sam doesn't come after you.
A five-year-old boy taking action, saving his mother's life. What he did that has earned him top honors from firefighters.
You're not going to believe this, but...
What's up?
I got some good news and I got some bad news. Good news is I got a new Ducati. They're way more affordable than they used to be. And the bad news is I kind of hooked up with your girlfriend.
You what? You got a Ducati?
Yeah!
Oh, nice work,
right?
Those are awesome.
They're so fast.
Oh, they are.
In this Sonoran Living Spotlight, we are talking about those awful trouble spots and how to get rid of them without downtime. This is Tamara Aragon of Reveal Body Contouring Centers. So tell us about the cool sculpting procedure. How does it work?
Okay, it's a process called cryolipolysis. So cryo meaning to freeze. We freeze and crystallize fat cells and they go through a natural cell death process.
So how do we get rid of the fat?
We actually eliminate that through our lymphatic system.
Okay, so just a natural process. So let's look at some before and afters. What kind of results are clients seeing?
Results expect to see about 20 to 25% reduction in the area that's treated. It's really, really nice. They expect to start to see things at about 30 days, wow factor at 90 days.
Wow, so you won't see instant results, no. But over about a 3-month period, you'll start shrinking.
Absolutely.
Are there any side effects with this?
There's really no side effects or downtime. Many of our patients go right back to the gym the day that they're treated.
Oh, wow. Yes. So that's amazing.
Absolutely.
So what are they telling you when they come in for that free initial consultation?
Yes.
You will advise them on what body parts to get the CoolScoop?
Yeah, if they're a good candidate, usually between 5 and 30 pounds from their ideal body weight, active, healthy lifestyle, and they have grabbable, pinchable fat, then we'll move forward with the treatment in that area.
All right. And you actually do the treatments.
I
are
do.
Are they overwhelmed with the results?
Absolutely. People will come in at their 6-week follow-up and say that their clothes are fitting better, and they really get excited about that, you know, final 3-month follow-up.
And how many treatments do we need?
Well, it just depends on the presence of adipose tissue in the area.
Okay, so maybe one, maybe more, but
yeah.
You'll let us know.
Absolutely.
All right, let's give you some information. Reveal Body Contouring has a special offer for you. The first 10 people to call will receive a free initial consultation, plus a 25% off any CoolSculpting package. 602-707-7260 or visit freezeitaway.com. This Sonoran Living Spotlight is paid for by Reveal Body Contouring.
All right. We want to start with a
yes.
live view of the big talker of the day. The wait is finally over. April is a mama, and her baby calf is right there at the bottom of our screen.
Yeah,
can we lose the...
There we go. Oh, so cute. She's up walking around now.
You were just reading some interesting stats from Good Morning America.
Crazy. 1.2 million people watched April give birth this morning.
Wow.
Can you believe it?
And so all of this we watched unfold during ABC 15 mornings. Mm-hmm. The birth started happening kind of right around 5 o'clock. By 7, the baby was out. And then they say it took 45 minutes for the calf to get up on those wobbly
yeah.
new little legs and stumble around. But look at how different, what a difference a couple, you know, hours make.
I know. I saw her struggle a little bit, but it was so exciting to finally see that little baby get up and start walking around and bonding with mama. So cute.
Wow.
Right? I know.
The most watched birth ever, it feels like.
I know.
Anticipated, really, certainly. The most anticipated.
It was like weeks in the making, months, it felt like. Mm-hmm. Hey, there are only 4 days left to file your taxes, but that does not mean that you should rush through them.
As Angie Cayley shows us with our Smart Shopper team, you can get more bang for your refund buck if you put just a little bit of thought into where it goes.
Isn't this what it feels like when your tax refund comes in, like it's raining money? Well, don't go buy that big ticket item just yet.
I mean, the majority of, you know, as consumers, we've already spent it before we even have the money.
Local financial advisor Ben Belanger says he sees it all too often. Then the refund ends up being less than expected. And many times people spend it, yet don't have much in savings, if anything.
Start or increase their emergency fund, at least have a 6-month cash reserve or emergency fund. That way, if an unexpected item comes up, you don't obviously then go get the credit card.
According to the IRS, the average tax refund is $3,000. If the temptation for a new TV is too great, you don't even have to save it all. You can save a portion of it. But if you really don't need that cash right now, financial common sense says invest it, even at a 5% return rate.
In 10 years, you know, a $3,000 average tax return can grow to approximately $6,000. And in 20 years, you can get close to $8,000.
And really, if you're getting a big refund, it means you're paying in too much. Talk to your HR director so it feels like it's raining down money every month. For more, go to our website, abc15.com/smartshopper.
If you made some extra cash driving for Uber or maybe renting out your house on Airbnb, you do need to check your taxes twice. That is considered freelancing, so that means that you're going to be responsible for paying those taxes, not the company. If you drove for Uber or Lyft, you need a Schedule C form with your return. You also want to make sure to keep track of what it costs you to do these jobs. You know, things like car washes, how much did you pay in gas? Also repairs, they're all tax deductible in that ride sharing industry. Now, if you rented out your home for less than 2 weeks, you're in the clear. You don't have to pay any taxes. But anything more than that, maybe you rent out your home on Airbnb for the summer, you're going to need to fill out a Schedule E form. Speaking of Uber, they are giving a look at books for the first time. It shows the ride-sharing company lost $2.8 billion last year. Don't feel too bad, though. Its gains far outweighing the losses. Uber booked $20 billion worth of rides in 2016. Technically, the company is privately held, so it doesn't have to provide financial data. Officials voluntarily gave up that information to Bloomberg.
Well, get ready to explore the great outdoors for National Park Week. It is your chance to get to know some new places and take it easy on your wallet. This weekend, visit any national park for free. You're also going to have a chance to get out and explore next weekend as well. Park officials are going to celebrate Earth Day and Park Ranger Day, too.
And it's going to be such a great day to head out to one of our many wonderful parks.
Yeah.
Maybe you want to take a hike. Hey, maybe your Easter weekend plans have you driving up to the high country to check it out up there. It's going to be sunshine across the board.
So no excuse not to get out and enjoy this weekend.
It's so nice. Let's go ahead and take a look outside right now. Sunshine over downtown Phoenix this morning. Chandler, start off a little slow, 59 degrees still. Mesa, you've warmed up to 67. Glendale already up in the 70s. Same with Deer Valley this morning. Across the valley, Goodyear still cool at 57, Buckeye at 58. And in the East Valley, Fountain Hills warming up 68 degrees already for you. We're 66 in Scottsdale. Taking a look at currents across the state right now, slowly but surely starting to warm up in the high country. The Grand Canyon at 46 degrees, Flagstaff at 48. They started off the morning below freezing. A little further south, 61 in Sedona, 61 in Payson. We're at 70 degrees here in Phoenix. Looking at clouds and radar, clear as could be. That has been keeping us nice and cool. No clouds in the forecast for today, although you see a few off to our southwest. That is going to start to move into our state come Sunday, and that's also going to keep our temperatures a little bit warmer. Today, though, it's going to be gorgeous across the board. We're talking about 80s for most of southwestern Arizona. We're talking about mid-70s along the Rim. 65 is your warm-up for Flagstaff today. We expect to top out at 88 degrees here in the valley in Phoenix, and most of the valley will see temperatures mirroring that. 88 in Mesa, 88 in Gilbert. 86 will be a little cooler out in Apache Junction. Notice those overnight lows, though. We're going to have a clear night. It's also going to cool things down by morning by about 30 degrees. But for today, gorgeous sunny skies, about 3 degrees above average, 87 degrees in Surprise, 88 in Litchfield Park. Looking at that Easter Sunday forecast, if you're waking up bright and early, maybe sunrise service is on tap for you, 62 degrees. So maybe a light jacket to go with that new Easter outfit. If you're planning on having Easter brunch, 84 degrees. It'll be really nice, so maybe sit outside. But then also take note, by mid-afternoon, we're going to warm up back into the 90s, 92 expected tomorrow. And then those 90s are going to stick around for the start of our work week. Tuesday looking to be the warmest day on tap at 94. But then breezes start to move into our state. We'll start to drop the temperatures back in the valley into the upper 80s, which will look a lot like what we are going to see today.
Many locations. Right. No, hey, thank you. Sorry, we got a little sidetracked because we're talking Eggs Benedict here today. The reason Easter brunch, you know, usually makes any restaurant pretty packed, right? We'll add on top of that Eggs Benedict Day. National Eggs Benedict Day is tomorrow.
That's right.
Can you believe it? My goodness. I know. I'm sorry. I should have had it marked on my calendar. I know. I've got Chef Mario here joining us from US Egg, but also this is really special. Your dad is here.
I brought the boss here. Everyone's got to be on their good behavior today.
Yes.
That's all I got to say.
All right, sir. I will be very good. Here's an incredible thing, though. They are going to be celebrating their 31st anniversary, and Dad is the one who started it, actually in Iowa, then brought your first location here was in Tempe.
Yep, right. We're an Arizona-based, family-owned and operated company, celebrating our 31st year anniversary.
Well, I love that you brought Dad out here. That's
you.
Awesome.
We're excited to be in the valley this long, and I want to make you guys some hollandaise today.
Yeah, okay, so let's talk about Eggs Benedict. Nohei loves them, and you guys have a few different varieties.
We've got a few different varieties. We've got a veggie Benedict, which we have on the very end.
Let's
over
see, right
here.
Right over here.
That's our veggie Benedict.
That looks delicious with avocado.
Yeah. And this is our gluten-free French toast for all of our gluten-free guests.
Got that a lot in Scottsdale.
This is just our traditional, our traditional Benedict here.
Okay, don't mess with the classic, right?
And I'm going to assemble this California Benedict here. And these are our famous protein pancakes that my Father Oscar came up with 31 years ago that we've been serving all these years.
Looks delicious. Okay, so let's have you get started in doing this. Let me ask you,
ask me.
Easter Sunday,
You guys must be packed those days.
We're really packed. It's our second busiest day of the year besides
Mother's Day. I knew it.
You got it. So I'm just adding a little bit of sea salt here to those eggs.
Okay.
For the hollandaise, a little bit of pepper. And the key to this is just adding the butter in.
Butter.
Not all at the same time, but,
of course,
just a little.
That's what makes it taste
just so good. A little bit at a time here.
All right. Okay, let me ask you this. Can people still go tomorrow?
People can still
go
tomorrow.
Ahead.
We're open.
We
We've got six Valley locations. Go to our website, usegrestaurant.com, and see which location is closest to you.
Okay, let me ask, too, because you guys are turning 31 this year, thanks to Dad. So what are you guys doing? Something special?
Something special? Well, we're just doing all of our Eggs Benedict for National Eggs Benedict Day.
But you're having a new menu or rolling out some new items for the anniversary?
Okay, you can't tell anybody, but we're doing a secret menu.
You're doing a secret menu. He's going to tell me during the break. I'm going to see if I could squeeze it out of him then.
We've got a secret menu and
we only have about 10 seconds.
10 seconds. Okay, here's our California Benedict with the beautiful hollandaise sauce and fresh avocado
looks
on
great.
There. You better believe it.
All
tastes
right, guys.
Even better.
Make sure you check out US Egg tomorrow, National Eggs Benedict Day. No, hey, I think we've got an update, do we?
We do, Allison. We've been following breaking news this morning, and we have new developments now as first responders are on scene of a very serious crash at 67th Avenue and Glendale. We are told a semi-truck has hit a car. Mary Ellen Resendez just getting to the scene. Mary Ellen, I know it's all very fresh. I can see a lot going on behind you. Tell me what you've learned.
Well, we just finished speaking with Glendale police, and we want to tell you that it was actually the truck that hit the semi-truck. So I'm going to take you to the scene right now. You can see that blue truck right there. According to Glendale police, that truck went head-on with the semi-truck, causing that semi-truck to actually roll over. We're told the driver of the semi-truck is okay. He sustained very minor injuries. The driver of that blue pickup truck that you see right there, not so lucky. We are unsure exactly what his injuries are. He was very severely injured. They have flown him out of here to a nearby trauma center. So that's what we know right now as far as what took place. Now this is 67th Avenue just south of Maryland, and we want to let you know that this is completely shut down. Glendale police and Glendale Fire asking anyone in this area to avoid this area while they investigate this accident. Again, the driver of that pickup truck, we're told, somehow or another went head on with that semi truck. He has been flown to the hospital. We're not exactly sure the extent of his injuries, other than that they're very severe. Live in Glendale, Mary Ellen Resendez, ABC 15, Arizona.
Oh, certainly in the front of that truck doesn't look great. We, of course, will keep updates coming on abc15.com. Thanks.